Children's, here the in our last class we discussed about the court and the justice and army about during the Sangam period. Here today we move on to the next topic as Thinai in Sangam society. What is meant by Thinai? Here Thinai in the sense here Thinai denotes the land. Here the land was divided into five types. They divided the five types of land atmosphere. For those five things are Kurinji, Mullai, Marudam, next thing Neidal, and then finally Palai. These are the five division of Thinai. Here for these five divisions they followed the different way of landscape and occupation, and also they used the different words to call the people, and also they followed the different way of worship. They followed the different god to worship. Today we are going to discuss about these things. First thing, we see the landscape for these five land. First thing, for Kurinji the landscape was the landscape of Kurinji was Palmyra flowers. What? Palmyra flowers in the sense panaipu. Here in Tamil it was called as the Malayum, Malai Sarnda Pagudigalum, because Kurinji, the place of Kurinji, was called covered with full of hill areas. So Kurinji was called as Malayum, Malai Sarnda Idangalum. Next one, the landscape of Mullai was forest region, because it was known as Kaadum, Kaadu Sarnda Idangalum. So it was fully covered with the forest region. Next thing, the landscape of Marudam, it was fully covered by river. So it was called as riverine region in the sense vayalum, vayal sarnda idangalum. Next thing, landscape of Neidal, it was coastal area. It was called a coastal area in the sense because it was fully covered with the coast sea. So it was called a coastal area. In Tamil it was called a kadalum, kadal sarnda idangalum. Next one, finally, for the landscape of Palai, it was called the parshland. It was called the parshland. Parshland in the sense it was like a hard land, very hard. Simply it was like a desert area. In Tamil it was called Varanda Nilam. These are the landscape for these five Thinai. Next we move on to the occupation. What are all the occupation they followed in these five Thinai? Here Kurinji in the sense Malayum, Malai Sarnda Idangalum. Already we see Kurinji, Malayum, Malai Sarnda Idangalum. Here they followed the occupation as hunting. Their main occupation was hunting. Next Mullai, here they followed the herding. Herding in the sense simply Anirai Maithal in the sense like Aadu Maithal, Aadu Maipangala. Likewise they followed the it was the occupation of Mullai. Next Marudam, here main occupation was agriculture. And then Neidal, here they follow the fishing, because Neidal, the place of Neidal was surrounded by sea area. So there fishing is a important occupation for there. And then finally, Palai. They followed the occupation of heroic deeds. Heroic deeds in the sense, Veera Chayalgal. Their occupation was heroic deeds. Next one, we move on to the peoples. Peoples, they called us in Kurinji. The people in Kurinji, the people was called in Kurinji. The people was called Kuravar. In Kurinji, the people was called Kuravar and Kurati. As a men was called Kuravar and women was called Kurati. Next thing, in the place of Mullai, people was called Ayar. Same, the men was called Ayar and then women were called Ayachiyar. Next thing, Marudam. The place of Marudam people were called Ulavan Uladiyar. What? Ulavan. Men were called Ulavan, women were called Uladiyar. Next thing, Neidal. The place of Neidal people were called Parathavar. What? Parathavar. Parathavar as a men. For women, they were called as Nuladiyar. They were called as Nuladiyar. Finally, in the place of Palai, they were called Maravar, Maraviyar. Maravar, Maraviyar. These are the names used to call the peoples lived in those areas. Next thing, we move on to the god. What are all the god? They prayed. In the place of Mullai, they prayed the god as Murugar. And then, the place of Kurinji, they worshipped the god Murugar. Next, in Mullai, they prayed worshipped the god Mayon. Mayon in the sense Mayavar. And then, in Madurai, they worshipped the god Indiran. Next thing, in Neidal, they worship the god Varunan. Varuna Bhagavan is a famous god for to pray the god Varunan because of the rain. Next one, finally, Palai, they worship the god Kotravai. These are the five different gods worshipped by those people. Next thing, according to the fertility land, was classified, Marudam. Marudam was known as Menpulam. Marudam was the place. Marudam was called as Menpulam. Menpulam here, it was very famous for production of paddy and sugar cane. These are the two things produced in the place of Marudam. It was called the Menpulam. And also it is called a fertile land. Next thing, except the place of Neidal, remaining three was called as Vanpulam. What? Vanpulam. Vanpulam in the sense hard land. It was called the hard land. Here, pulses and dry grains were produced. These two were produced in Vanpulam. These are about the Tinai. Next thing, we move on to the status of women. Here, during the Sangam period, for women, there is no restriction in social life. There is no restriction in social life. Next thing, during the period of Sangamesh, there is a lot of educated women. There they lived a lot of educated women. And also, there is a 40 women poets were there. There is a 40 women poets were there in Sangam period. And then, they have a rights to make a own decision. They have a rights to make a own decision during the time of their marriage. And then finally, they have equal shares from their parents' property. For both sons and daughter, they have an equal share from their parents' property. These are the status of women during the Sangam period. And then here, in your book, there is some famous women poets during the Sangamesh. First person, Avvayar. Avvayar is one of the women poet during the Sangam period. And Velli Vidyar. And then Kakai Padiniyar. Avvayar, Velli Vidyar, Kakai Padiniyar, and then Adimandiyar. Next one, Ponmudiyar. These are the some of the women poets lived in the period of Sangam age. Next one, we move on to the religious beliefs and social divisions. Religious belief and social divisions. Religious belief and social division. They portray the primary god. They portray Seyon, or otherwise called as Murugan, as a primary god. And then during Sangam period, they worshipped the gods, or except the Murugan, they worshipped some other gods during the Sangam period. Those are Shivan. Next thing, Mayon, and then Indiran, and then Varunan, and then Kotravai. These are the remaining gods worshipped by during the Sangam period. And then also they followed the hero stone worship. Also, not only these type of worship, also they followed the worship of hero stone. What is meant by hero stone, children? Anyone know what is meant by hero stone? Okay, we discuss about the hero stone here. In our olden days, they have a respect towards the heroes who have died during the period of war. For those people, they built a stone for the remembrance of who are the persons sacrificed their lives during the war time. Stone was mentioned as a hero stone, and everyone they worshipped behind the hero stone. This is called the worship of hero stone. and then also Buddhism and Jainism were also the coexisted of these Sangamesh. What? Buddhism and Jainism was also the coexist of these two these Sangam age. As like Northern India, caste did not develop in our Tamilagam. Yeah, during Sangam period, the caste did not develop in our Tamilagam. This is about the religious belief, children. Next, we move on to the dress and ornaments. What are all the dress code for dress code and ornaments they used here? In the dress, muslin, silk, and then fine cotton. Fine cotton in the sense, best quality of cotton dress. What is called the fine cotton? Muslin is one of the variety of cloth. We all know what is meant by silk. These three are the main dress they can be used. Also, these three can be wear by the rich people. Muslin, silk, fine cotton. These three can be wear by the rich people. But the common people or as a normal people used to wear two pieces of cotton. They wear the two pieces of cotton alone. Normal people. And then clothes which were very thinner than the skin of snake can be referred during the Sangam age. During the Sangam age only, the clothes which were very thinner than the skin of snake can be identified. And then they can use the flower. They can use the flowers to decorate their hairs. And also both men and women use the lot of different ornaments. Some ornaments are here. Gold. We all know gold, silver is a simple casual one. Then pearls, gold, silver, pearls, precious stone. They use the precious stones. Then conch shells in the sense sung. They use the conch shells and beards. Beards in the sense beads. We all know beads. These are the some ornaments used during the Sangam age, Sangam period. Also, they used the aromatic perfumes. In the sense, not a artificial one. It is a natural perfume. These are about the dress and ornaments used during the Sangam peoples. Next, we move on to the arts. They have a variety of musical references such as drums, flute, then yaul. They have a lot of musical references such as drums, flute, then yaul. Here, Karikalan, one of the famous, Karikalan was one of the famous person for seven notes of music. He was a famous person for seven notes of music. What is mean by seven notes of music? He was a famous for seven notes of music. Seven notes in the sense, Yelisai Vallavan. He was called as a, and also famous for a Yelisai Vallavan. Who? Karikalan. Then who sing the bards were called as Paanar and Viraliyar? Those were called Paanar and Viraliyar. They sang the song of bards. They sang the song by bards. Then Kanigaiyar performed the dance here. Kanigaiyar. Kanigaiyar performed the dance. He was famous for dance. Then another thing, Kuthu. During the Sangam period, Kuthu was the famous in arts. Now in nowadays also there is some we are able to see some performance about Kuthu. Kuthu in the sense like a drama, nothing but it is about the drama. They take a one story and they try to act as a act such a story in the way of Kuthu. It is simply about the drama, folk drama. Next thing, Kuthu is considered as the important and famous role of ancient period. And also during the Sangam period, they developed the Muttamil. During the Sangam period, they developed the Muttamil. Muttamil, what are all the Muttamil? Iyal, Isai, Nadakam. They developed these three things. These are about the arts. Students, next we move on to the occupations. Occupations in the period of Sangam people. What are all the occupations they followed? Main thing was agriculture, cattle rearing, fishing, and hunting. These are the famous and popular work during a popular occupation during the Sangam period. And also some craftsman in the sense kaivinai tholil. We all know the craft, no? Likewise, there is some craftsman. Those are carpenter. One thing, carpenter, and then blacksmith. Carpenter, blacksmith, goldsmith. Carpenter, blacksmith, goldsmith, porters. These are the craftsmen. Also, there is another occupation, weaving. There is another occupation, weaving. Weaving is a full-time occupation for everyone. And part-time occupation for the farmers. Weaving is a part-time occupation for farmers. And also the full-time occupation for others. Thank you, children.